thank Reverend Pat for an invitation to be here. Last year I was here just by chance. I was on my way to Paris to collect a Platinum Award for excellence for my company. And it was just fortuitous that I was in Britain at the same time and allowed me to be here with your celebrations. This year I'm here for the celebrations.
Praise the Lord.
And I'm so delighted. And I want to pray. But I've been on a mission, and I have been on a serious mission of transferring the way we think in the Baptist community. And over the last several years, I've spoken in Grenada, St. Vincent, and in New York, in California. I just came back from leading the Liberation Celebrations in Canada, in Toronto, and I'm here today. And therefore, I'm delighted, I'm humbled, I'm respectful to have met for the first time Professor Gus. And Professor Gus, I want to say to you, my style is the reward for good work. The reward for good work is more. And you have some work to do in Trinidad and Tobago. And the reason for that invitation to him is that when you say Mecca, you understand what that means? The Islamic people and they turn to the east. Amen?
Amen.
When you say the Vatican, what do you say?
Rome.
Rome, the Roman Catholics, and they know where to turn. No matter where the Roman Catholic Church is in the world, they know you must head to
Rome.
To Rome. When you say Canterbury, what do you mean? Eh? And you know, wherever the Anglican Church is, you must face them. So when you say spiritual Baptist, why are you looking all over the world? Huh? You have to turn to the Caribbean. Regardless of where the church is, our centerfold is in the Caribbean. And we must understand that. And because we have lost sight of that vision of the centerfold, we are now losing members in our churches because they are becoming more open Bible than serving God in the way that God has given the spiritual Baptist to serve Him. God has been good unto us. God has been merciful. He has been gracious. He gave us a special way to serve Him. And sir, could you stand up a moment, please? No, you know that point, and I got a Jesus. Prover. Could you stand? Let us celebrate the Prover, please. The coming together of the churches. I think our sister was there. And in that I said in the speech, no longer are you here for the watchmen and the proofers. Where are those? And they were significant in us understanding our own way to go to God. Prover, may God bless you. Last year, for the first time, out of our national liberation celebrations, We got all the archbishops, Archbishop Grenville Williams from Barbados, Archbishop John Noel from Grenada, Archbishop Johnny Jones from St. Vincent, a couple of the archbishops and bishops from New York who are visiting, and all our archbishops from Trinidad from our National Congress of Incorporated Baptist Organization. We got together for the first time and started to talk about the need for us to focus on our oneness, because the more we are splintered, the more we are going to be laughed at, and therefore we'll never get the resuscitation, the restoration, the whatever we want. We never get it, because when they look at us, they're not seeing one. And therefore, in that regard, I want to extend my appreciation to Reverend Pat for her personal struggle, and to those of you who are with her in this struggle. But part of the absence of the people is the power. And power only comes from whom? Eh? When man takes power to himself, no way, Jose. So as we continue this struggle, we have to find a way to speak. So I was about to make a point that the conversation we are having in Trinidad is that 1917 was a byproduct of slavery and the treatment of our people by the masters. And that it goes even to 1785, when the French rich trader was in Grenada, and when he proclaimed that his real mission is the expansion of the Roman Catholic Church. And therefore, in that whole process, our behaviors towards each other has been engineered. And therefore, we have to find a way. It has to take Professor Goss and a lot of the scholars to help us re-engineer our thinking.
Oh, yes.
And in re-engineering our thinking, re-engineer our behavior towards each other.
Yes.
Because we continue to be like crabs in a barrel, and the best exercise we can do is to pull down each other. Instead of supporting us. Demonstrate our love for each other. We cannot be speaking Christianity and treating each other like that. Oh, wait, no way. We cannot, in the spirit of liberation, not recognize what the Bible says. The scripture said, 2 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 17. What it says? In part, where the spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. Say it with me, where the Spirit of the Lord is. Say it with me, where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. Where there's liberty, there's freedom. One of the things we did this year in our liberation celebrations is that we had a whole month of activities so that we could focus on the youth, focus on the leadership, focus on the whole church and all our churches, because we are finding more and more, you can know the history well, all our churches were behind somebody's house. So therefore the church is in the name of the house owner. So when we say churches come sit together, because I hold a very, if I can say so myself, a very good position in government, and therefore I use that position to help our churches. Come, let's sit. Come, let's put documents together to get your church improved. What happens? The property is in the name of the owner. Government cannot help the owner, but can help the church. So part of the whole rethinking is to get the churches registered properly.
Yeah.
And that the properties of the church be sold aside. If that doesn't happen, we will never grow to the point that we have to grow.
Sure.
1917 was the most draconian act against our people. But as a Trinidad, don't forget in St. Vincent. Trinidad and St. Vincent, we have now talking a language, because together we have to speak out in a certain way. Because 4 years before the 1917 Act in Trinidad, there was an act called the Shakerism Prohibition Ordinance. And I said it last time, I'm going to say it again. It came about because the white governor, and I'm sure you might have been on a white horse, went to Mako, a Baptist meeting, because he started to hear the drums and the singing and the chanting, and he wanted to know. And the horse called Power. And he was chocolate.
Love my talk.
And poor fella, I tell him. You're so angry that that was the genesis for the prohibition ordinance. The Shakerism, because they were all Shakers in St. Vincent. If Jamaica converts or converted in Barbados after 1957, when Archbishop Grenville went and started to become operated, became tie heads. And that really led to, because you know, we call fashion in the Caribbean, the governor in Trinidad and Tobago decided that that was needed in Trinidad. So in 1970, the shelter prohibition ordinance was declared. And we are saying, notwithstanding that in 1951 it was revealed, the marginalization continues. But part of the marginalization is that out of now, our people are not proud to say that they are spiritual Baptists, shelters. Recently, I employed a young lady at my job because when they looked at the phone, she was bold enough to write spiritual Baptist. I told her, find a job for her. But you know, we have to check out our company policy. I am the makeup company policy. I'm the executive chairman. I am saying, find a job for her. Because she was bold enough to say that she's spiritual Baptist. The only way I could have had a successful year this year for our liberation celebration, isn't that all I did? I didn't use those current, all our Archbishop Marcelo, you all are the ceremonial guys. I will get a planning team together, and I got a team of professionals. Masters in green finance, masters in science, team of professionals, and we got together and planned our activity. It was the most successful. Minister Joni Williams called me the next morning, because she went to all the celebrations in Trinidad, and said, I must admit, you all had it clean. That is because we did the planning. Because if you fail to plan, you are really planning to fail. One of the things I should have mentioned, when I said all the archbishops together, I just have to confess that I forgot a very important name, which is the Archbishop of Bishop Clark, Archbishop Clarence Basden of the NESB, because he was present. And everybody in Trinidad knows that he really does not vote. So the fact he decided to come and meet with us to talk it, and we are now saying to people, don't tell us again that we fragmented, because we are doing things about it. And if you look at the Islamic groups, they have about 16 of them, different groups. If you look at the Hindu sect, they have about 18 of them. Nobody said anything. Leave us alone. We'll fix our business. But we want to say something as I bring to close, because I know time is upon us. A conversation is about to happen. And that conversation, that strategic conversation, will start to happen with the Missions High Commission in Trinidad. We are saying that the reason why our churches are in the back and hiding is because of the prohibition ordinance. I don't want to know anything about the repealing. And don't try to make me feel good that you have repealed it and therefore all sins just wash away. We have to go there. If a family member should die and you do not go through the mourning process, that family member is not gone. You have not allowed the spirit to go. So I'm saying, listen, we have not gone through and faced boldly all the challenges of slavery. We have not faced boldly. A lot of Americans and British people are now going to Cape Coast Castle on the edge of Ghana to feel what is felt by our ancestors when they reached out what they call the door of no return, Mafa, and all the struggles across the land. I will want to see that the British government, among others, sponsor a whole ship of flowers traveling from Ghana across to this part of the world, not this part, but across to the West Indies. And we must be sprinkling the flowers and praying for our ancestors, all those who sprint us. What we did for our celebrations this year is that we went to the Queen's Park Savannah. We walked the Savannah until we identified spiritually the tree that was most offensive to our people. And we found it. And when we searched, there was a gravesite close by and a watered road for the horses, where they went after to drag our people across the Savannah, where they tied them and sometimes whip or hang them. And we had to perform a major spiritual ceremony just to be able to stay there the next day to have a celebration. So we have put those ancestral spirits to rest on that spot. We have many other spots in Trinidad to find and to bring to rest the spirits of our ancestors. And don't tell me that that is un-Christian, because every time we talk about the ancestors, we have some Christians turning up their noses. But that is my grandfather. That is my grandmother. Can I not recognize them? But those are my ancestors. And if you do not have... come here or come to the West Indies just like that.
True.
It wasn't your choice. Some of you came to England by choice, but your parents didn't come by choice. And it's high time we recognize that and remember that. You don't have to live it. You don't have to become what became of them, but you must know, because it's only when you know now you can make decisions about your own future. If you're in the absence of information, you're ignorant. And therefore, as we celebrate Spiritual Baptist Shelter Liberation in London, there are some things I'm saying to you all you need to read. There's a book by Thomas called The Slave Trade. It's as thick as this, but read it. There's a book called The Door of No Return. Read it. You have a lot of books you need to read, or go on the net and find stuff. Because if you don't know, the absence of ignorance will continue to be who we are. It was a deliberate act to separate our languages, a deliberate act to make sure that we do not communicate with each other. And the boldness enough that even when in Haiti, when Toussaint Louverture did what he had to do, they charged Haiti, they charged them for what? For their own independence. Part of Haiti's struggle, they knocked up the head, they had to pay to France to be free. Your own freedom. So don't make a mistake and feel like we're really free. Don't make that mistake, you know. God has been good to us. And we have found a way to express that goodness. But if we don't come and bring some discussion to the table, we will never be able to say, free at last. Thank God Almighty, we are free at last. So I want to thank you all very much for the patience, for waiting, for forgiving me for my misbehavior, but at the same time, understanding that we are on a mission. And those of you who stayed, you're part of the mission. Those who left, may God bless them. But those of you who stayed, that's the mission. So that in complimenting you for staying, I want to compliment the Spiritual Baptist faith, led by trying to tell me she's a Muslim. She is. She never put a banner up there saying she's not. You know that? She is. So give her a special. We are in a struggle together. And do not see yourself separate from us. The challenge I want to put on the table is that we must find a way to twin this celebration with our celebrations in Trinidad.
Oh yeah.
We have to find a way to twin it. There mustn't be a struggle at the last moment to find out if somebody is coming, because if that is not understood, then the ways to deal with it will be, you have a longer planning line. But let us, as part of what we are doing here, if there's one thing we can walk away from, is let us find a way to twin. Regardless of which archdiocese we belong to, at the end of the day, we have to twin the liberation celebration. We just did a piece in Tobago. Tobago has a group called the Tobago United Liberated Baptists. Of all the groups in Tobago. But we just did a twin with them. We, out of some of the funds we got from government, we helped fund them in Tobago to make sure that they had the best. And this year, there's a post all over the world. They had one of the best for Tobago in Tobago because of the oneness.
Alright.
And therefore, we cannot see ourselves in New York, in Toronto. That's part of the discussion. We're twinning with Toronto's liberation to make sure that on the table we have a consistency across the land. And that that consistency will help us deal with the leadership that we need for the years to come. I'm telling our archbishops, every one of them average age 76, 66 for the youngest. And they're not, when they come to meetings, I'm not seeing a young bishop with them. and say, no, we have to talk that to the leadership. We have to get the youth, and they must not be afraid to say that they speak their Baptist. When I was 7 years old, I was in Guapo Government School singing. And a teacher named Miss Yap passed in my ear and said, what happened? You're Baptist or what? Because of the way I was singing, she didn't know I really, Uriah Basler took me in the water, they six. I came from that village, Guapo. She didn't know that. I never told her. But what did they do? Let me go on the ground. So for years, I was a Roman Catholic. I liked and all those kinds of things. Until about 14, 16 years ago, Spirit of the Lord said, hello, this is not for you. Go where you belong. That's why I'm here today. Because I declared that I was a spiritual Baptist.
Boy.
On March 30th, coming up to March 30th, 1999, I told the then president, let us send a message to the spiritual Baptist community of Petitrin. He said, I won't do that. I said, why not? He said, that's a minority religion. I said, do you know how much spiritual Baptists in this company? I said, I meet them every week. Hundreds of them in different parts of the company. He said, no, I'm not doing that. Anyway, we had a long discussion. At the end of it, I said to him that he offended me. He didn't know at that time that there was a shelter. Since after that, every time I do something in the executive corridor, and I move a pen from here to there, one of them look like me some Obi and Blue. And then on September 30th, September 10 o'clock the night, he told me from October 1st, I'm seconded to another state corporation. And he thought I would have resisted. I said, really? Next morning at 8 o'clock, I was at that company. And I went and I woke. Everybody thought I came there happy because the Spirit of the Lord is upon me.
Amen.
Yeah? I have to be happy all the time. And therefore, I just went. And he didn't know the favor he did me. Every time I sit down, hug him. You don't know why I'm hugging him up. Because the current job that I had, he didn't realize. I just finished my master's degree. And I did really well. I got 9 distinctions out of 14. And I only missed getting a first class honor because I had a minor surgery, just around some exams. And therefore, when I went to that company, I had a chance to experiment with every concept that I learned in my MBA. So during that time now, I said to someone, next election, we're going to have a change of government. And what you want to bet, I will have a seat. Because I have really skills. I have a lot of skills. And two numerous dimensions. He said, you want to talk in locality? I say, I see tomorrow, and I don't see yesterday. That's my thing. I see, you know, I see tomorrow. So when he had a change of government, and they realized that I became the first executive chairman in the country, he called me and said, hello. You and the chief spoke about it? We never spoke about it. But I can do all things. And it was coming to know utterance. By thy word thou shalt be what? Condemned. By thy word thou shalt be? Come on. You know it? By thy word. Not somebody else's word. Has to be your word. You have to form your word by your word. Has to. And therefore, as we grow out of today, let your word, let your utterance, let that be the one that you want to shape your world. And this has nothing to do with the mother next door, the sister across the world. Has to be you and your decision. Nobody can make you do anything else but what you want to do. Some people say, I'll beat you when I drink my rum. You know that? Premeditation. A lot of people premeditate their behaviors and then try to cloud it into something else. We have the greatest gift to be a liberated people, beyond everybody else. We have the greatest gift, and we are not using it because we refuse to understand the talents that God has given unto us. And we like one with the one talent, ready to hide it. God, I know you like to teach people money. We have to be like the five of whom much is given what? So my friends, thank you very much for having me. Mother with me, at first, so she's shaking on the place. But you know, this place has to have the accommodating spirit. And only the Baptist churches provide it. So, thank you for being here. So,